Well, hello and welcome back to my latest video. Yes, another one, okay? I am churning through them now in this quicker format. The final three videos, fly, light fly, minimum weight, will follow tomorrow. And the final video, the kind of top 10 pound per decade scorers, will follow on the 26th, the day after tomorrow. So let's look at the top 10 ring-rated fighters by decade for the super flyweight. It's a fairly new division. Super flyweight started being rated in the late 80s. And thus, on this one, there's not much to report, really. They were all rated 1 year. We have Kaosai Galaxy topping it, albeit just for 1 year. We have Nana Yorkonadu in second place on 12. Gilberto Roman in third on 9. So not really much to say here. Thanom Saksith Baube, a fighter I'm not as familiar with as others. Santos Lassiar, of course. Welcome Nikita. Juan Polo Perez. So not really much to report there, other than Gilberto Roman, Konadu and Galaxy were the highest rated super flyweights of the 1980s, simply because there were no other years. So not much possibility to mix and match them up. It has been grinding work today, but I am getting there. Now, Kaosai Galaxy, of course, fought through the 80s, and as we have seen, okay, Kaosai Galaxy was actually rated at bantamweight. And that's the thing, you know, while super flyweight was not being rated, and when light flyweight was not rated until, you know, when that got rated, fighters were rated in other divisions, okay, so they had a chance to get rated there. So let's go to the 1990s, okay, super flyweight. And super flyweight in the 1990s, very low point total for the decade. The winner is pitcher Johnny Tapia, who was top 10 rated 5 years and top 3 rated 4 years. He got just over half century at 52 points. Sunkil Moon came next. I remember watching Sunkil Moon back in day. He was top 10 rated for 4 years. He was top 3 rated 3 years, and he scored 45 ring rating points. And Hiroshi Kawashima, he was top 3 rated all 3 years he was rated in the 90s, coming in with 42 points. Then we have fighters like Robert Quiroga. He was top 10 rated for 4 years. We have Jerry Penalosa, one of Freddie Roach's favourites, another excellent Filipino fighter. He was top 10 rated in the 1990s for 5 years. And Mark Too Sharp Johnson, who we'll also see at flyweight, he was top 10 rated for 2 years at super flyweight. My throat is really dry after all these videos. Yeah, Mark Too Sharp Johnson, top 10 rated for 2 years and top 3 rated for 2 years, scoring 30 ring rating points, Injin Cho and others. So basically in the 1990s, it was a very scrappy decade. Tapia edged it, followed closely by Sunkil Moon and Hiroshi Kawashima. But really, no dominant names there as such. You know, this is what I meant when we go through some at low weights. We get many decades where it's very scrappy. And like I said, it's because a lot of fighters are moving around, some coming into division, some going out of it. You know, it's much more wishy-washy. Now, obviously, the flyweight division is a longer historic division, rated from when the ratings were first incepted. So initially in there, we will have more standout names, as you will see. But some of these intermediate divisions, very scrappy, fighters coming and going, etc., etc. So let's leave the 1990s with Johnny Tapia on top there. Let us jump on to the 2000s. Only two more decades to go on this video, short division in history. In the 2000s, the top place is taken by Masamori Tokuyama, long-reigning champion, top 10 rated for 6 years, top 3 rated for 5 years, okay. Tokuyama scored 76 ring rating points. Alexander Munoz, he was top 10 rated for 8 years. He was the longest rated top 10 fighter of the decade at 8 out of 10 years, whereas Masamori Tokuyama, he was the longest top 3 rated fighter at 5 years. And no ring champion, interestingly. Munoz scored 67 points, coming in close behind Masamori Tokuyama. In third, we have Castillo, Miguel Castillo. He was top 10 rated 7 years, top 3 rated 4 years, scoring 65 ring rating points. While Fernando Montiel, of course, the multiweight champion, he was joint second longest rated, with Castillo in third place. Montiel, top 10 rated for 7 years, top 3 rated for 2 years, and he hit the half century. And 5th down to 10th place, including Kawashima and Penalosa, they were both rated last year, of course. In 7th place, we have Vic Darshinian, who also, I believe, if I recall, he does feature in flyweight. older videos already. I just can't recall the exact top 10s in older videos. But Vic Darshinian also top 10 rated and top 3 rated at Super Flyweight. He came in with 30 ring rating points. But definitely a slide for Masamori Tokiyama. The thing about this new division is, you know, it's a quick video. There's not as many decades covered. You know, we have Felix Mercado. He was rated for half the decade at 5 years, 2 years rated top 3. And like I say, it's going to be great to have these videos. So when I'm going through the lists I have on fighters to do on blue screen, quite a large list. Some of these guys like Hiroshi Kawashima, they are already due blue screens. So it'll be good to data mine the others and get them added in, people like Vic Darshinian, etc. So let's go to the last decade, last video today. I'm really tired now with it. In the 2010s, okay, we have Srisakitsaw Rungvisai. Srisakitsaw Rungvisai almost joined that elite club of five fighters who were rated across an entire decade, but he came in just shy at 9 years as a top 10 rated fighter in the 2010s. Saw Rungvisai was also top 3 rated for 8 years, and he was a ring champion for 1 year, so he scores just over 100 ring rating points at 102. And then in second place is Omar Andres Narvaez, top 10 rated for 6 years, top 3 rated half of those, and he scored 63 ring rating points. While Inoue, okay, was top 10 rated 4 years, top 3 rated all 4 of those years, and Inoue came third place with 60 ring rating points. Not bad, really, considering when he didn't fight there, you know, for too long. You know, he moved up to bantamweight in that decade as well. Carlos Cuadras, top 10 rated for 6 years, top 3 rated 4 years, 58 ring rating points. And of course Juan Francisco Estrada, who also may make impression like Rungvisai and others on this decade we're in now. Estrada, top 10 rated for 4, top 3 rated for 3, and a ring champion for 1.5 centuries. Then below that, okay, we have Roman Gonzalez and Cal Yafai. Now they were both top 10 rated for 4 years, top 3 rated 1 year. Yafai hit 27, Gonzalez hit 25. You know, Gonzalez, you know, was a bit hurt by the losses to Rungvisai after jumping up from flyweight, light flyweight, etc., over the earlier part of the decade. Then the reverses to Rungvisai dropped his rating, so it did affect his point total. Of course, we have Donny Nietes, Hugo Fidel Cazares, and Yerwin Anquejas as the bottom two. But definitely a decade for Srisakitsaw Rungvisai. Almost joined that elite club, just not quite there. So let us do a decade top finishers, okay, for the super flyweights. It's quite a simple one, not that many decades in this division, as you'll see at light flyer minimum two. So in the 1980s, Kausai Galaxy, okay, very short decade indeed. Kausai Galaxy came top with 15 ring rating points. While in the 1990s, okay, it belonged to Johnny Tapia. He was the longest or stroke more consistent rated super flyweight, coming in with 52 ring rating points. And in the 2000s, Masamori Tokiyama was the winner with a total of 76 points. And in the 2010s, the dominant rating force is Srisakitsaw Rungvisai with that score total of 102 points. So that ends my super flyweight video. So like I said, just to reiterate at the start, tomorrow comes the last big division, the flyweights. Later on in the day tomorrow will come the light flyweights and the minimum weights. Light fly and minimum are both small videos. And then the day after tomorrow, I will do that last big video where it will be a 40-plus minute one, and taking my time on that, listing the top 10 scorers across all divisions per decade. So 3 more to go, and then my special one, and then playlist done. I'm out for now.